Very good morning, people. A complete lecture of 50 minutes yesterday was occupied by these two slides. We just revise about it and then we'll go ahead. The most important aspect about climatology is the addition and the withdrawal of moisture. This moisture is in the form of water. And water is the most miraculous substance, I would say, in nature, basically, because at normal conditions, at the same time in different parts of the world, you'll have water in all the three forms of matter, that is solid, liquid, and gases as such. And all this happens in what is called as an hydrological cycle. The total amount of 320,000 cubic kilometers is the amount of water that evaporates and transfers into water vapor. Of this evaporated number, you will see that 284,000 cubic kilometers will fall back onto the oceans. The rest of it moves onto the land. To this, another 60,000 cubic kilometers gets added. And as a total of both of these, 96,000 cubic kilometers of precipitation takes place. Of these 96,000 cubic kilometers, a significant amount of it is stored in the form of snow, ice, water in lakes, surface lakes, underground lakes, and of course it infiltrates in the form of groundwater also. Leaving behind around 36,000 cubic kilometers of water to run off into the oceans as such. Okay, so eventually, those 36,000 cubic kilometers of water that comes onto the land has to leave land, basically because of the fact that this is a cycle. And any interference in these numbers obviously is going to cause a problem of excess amount of water being retained back onto the land, which would lead to marshes, etc., etc., or a deficit of water from the land surface, which will lead to drought conditions or dry conditions as such. Either of them are going to impact the climatic conditions, and in fact, the loss of water from the oceans or addition of more water onto the oceans will also cause, I think Tushar was saying about this yesterday, that will cause an eventual climatic change also. So this is the perception that we should have while we speak about the hydrological cycle in the subject of climatology. A very broad, a very macro scale, but I would say it indicates what is the importance of water in all these processes. When we look at water, a water molecule is basically two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atoms, and they're attached to each other at a degree of 108 degrees. Okay, so that is a basic bond as far as water is concerned. But then between solid water and its original form at the present circumstances, that's liquid water. In major parts of on the surface of this particular planet, there is a difference that in the process of structuring into a particular shape of ice or snow, you'll see that it leaves a lot of vacancies or air spaces, you could say, in between. And that is why you'll see that though it gets to be a solid, eventually it is volume wise, it increases itself, and as a consequence, it is not that dense. And that's why solid water tends to float on the surface. Solid water, that's ice, tends to float on the surface. And because, as far as water is concerned, the liquid form of water, it is not in a structure format. It is basically what flows in different direction. And that's a basic characteristic of any a liquid flow in nature as such. Then we came to understanding the change of matter from solid to liquid and liquid to gas and vice versa. Okay, this is a very common process that we tend to see happens around us. And one thing that we did not do yesterday, I said that I would be looking for the fact that sublimation and deposition. Sublimation is basically transfer of solid ice directly into gas, and I gave you the example of camphor. Kaparacha example, kapur jo asto, that's an example apun kal ghetlo hoto. And I said that I will have to check about the calories released in sublimation and calories absorbed in deposition as such. Okay, sublimation is a process in which a solid directly converts into a gaseous, that's vapor state, without going through a liquid state. The latent heat of sublimation at a particular temperature is the amount of heat required to convert the unit mass of solid into gas. So the released word, in fact, should be absorbed. Any deposition, instead of absorbed, it should be released. So my advice to you all is that when we take these good looking diagrams from the internet, we always have to check the sanctity of that particular diagram. Tyachyamadhye kahi error ahe ka kiwa kasa. We will have to one should actually check. Naitar tumhi, you would be carrying this false information to the audience, and at times there could be people in the audience who are more known to the physics and chemistry of this than it, and we are only looking at the geography of it, and that could be an embarrassment for the presenter in you as such. Another important aspect is how do we calculate this energy which is either released or absorbed as such. That's called as in calories as such. So one calorie is the amount of heat that is required to raise the temperature by 1 gram. Raise the temperature of 1 gram of water by 1 degree centigrade as such. Okay, so 10 calories is basically raising the temperature of 1 gram, the same 1 gram of water, by 10 degrees of centigrade as such. So you'll see that this is something that we have to keep in mind. You'll see that because changing from liquid to gas is going to be a process which involves more energy. We'll see that 600 calories are absorbed during evaporation. Bashpibhavan apan jala kal mantlela hai. Ani sandribhavan or condensation releases 600 calories. And I said that how convectional rainfall and how actually the whole process of condensation of water vapor into clouds is a process wherein the energy near the surface of the earth is transferred in at higher levels, and how it is used up, expended there through lightning and through thunder and so on and so forth at different points of time. However, you'll see that from melting, say melting of ice into liquid or freezing of liquid into ice as such, okay, you'll see that relatively a lesser amount of calories are required either ways as such. Also remember the fact that yesterday what I said, that till the last of the ice cube melts in that particular water, the water in the vessel will maintain that particular temperature, that's 0 degrees, though the vessel which is containing that particular liquid will not have the will have much higher temperature as such. Mala, I don't know how many of you all have tried this experiment at home today, yesterday. If you have not, you can still try it. Okay, ratri aaj zoptana dudacha bhanda fridge madhe thevaycha ani in fact akha bhanda thevaychi garaj nahi, chotyasya vati madhe tumhi te theva, je chote bhanda tumhi dusrya divshi thodasa gas var theu shakal as. So you can take that, and in fact of keeping it in the refrigerator, you keep it in the freezer, so that morning, the next day, you will find that all of it is frozen, and then you put that thodasa thamba ani you can then put it on the gas stove, you light up that gas and keep watching the melting of that particular frozen part of milk as such, and please and obviously take all the proper care, obviously. And then while it melts and melts and gets into the liquid format, okay, just dip your finger and check whether the temperatures have run, and then try to just touch the vessel, which is going to be hot. Be very careful as far as touching the vessel is concerned. So that is as far as melting is concerned, and then evaporation, that's from solid to liquid and liquid to gas, and back from gas to liquid is condensation, and from liquid to solid is freezing as such. All of this requires energy. This is measured in the form of calories. To the outer end, of course, we see a direct transfer from solid to gas, and that's called as sublimation. And you're going to see deposition, which is basically gas directly being deposited into solid formats, is what we have been doing yesterday. Then we move further. Okay, and as far as this further movement is concerned, the diagram that you see on your screens is nothing but the same thing that we have seen in a different way yesterday. But I thought this is a more better way of explaining, because this is what we actually see. Water on one side, water vapor on the other side, and of course towards the other extreme you have ice, that's the frozen form of water. The base here you can see 0 degrees to 100 degrees. Okay, it is in this phase that water stays to be in its liquid format. Anything above 100, it will transfer into water vapor. That doesn't mean that water should go should evaporate only at 100 degrees. This happens when you are actually forcing water to evaporate. But you'll see that otherwise also, an obvious question would be the fact that if it requires 100 degrees to Celsius to evaporate, ashpibhavanala 100 degree mug, as far as the temperature of ocean waters is concerned, sagaran madla je pani hai, does that have to go all the way to 100 degrees centigrade to vaporize? No, that is to do with vapor pressure. We are going to come to vapor pressure, etc., etc. This is a general understanding that we say that beyond 100 it tends to vaporize when you're adding energy to that. Okay, now further understanding of this, you'll see that we'll read actually through the diagram, solid, liquid and gas. Okay, you'll see that in ice you add 80 calories as such. Okay, that would make ice melt as such. Okay, and you add another 540 calories to that. Now these numbers do tend to vary with regards which area. Towards the equator, obviously the energy required to melt and vaporize is going to be less. Towards the poles, okay, the energy required to melt and evaporate is going to be more. So it depends in which part of the world the diagram is made. Okay, if it is made towards the equator, obviously the numbers are going to be a bit different. And if you go into Europe, if you go into the northern part of US and Canada, this is going to be a bit more different. But as I said, just like the heat budget concept that we saw, we have to understand what basically is all this thing meaning to us. Then you'll see that at a particular degrees, you when you have water, you add 540 calories to that, and that will yield you evaporation, and water vapor will get evaporated. When you remove 540 calories from this vapor, a latent heat of 540 calories will be released back into the atmosphere. That's called as latent heat of condensation. Ithe je lilela hai latent heat of vaporization, he ikde ahe var. Okay, this is called as latent heat of vaporization, and then condensation is going to be called as latent heat of condensation. Similarly, towards freezing, okay, you are going to call it as latent heat of fusion, and here you're going to call it as latent heat of melting as such. Okay, so and why we call it as latent heat, basically because you are not applying external energy. म्हणजे तुम्ही पाणी घेऊन फ्रीज मध्ये नाही ठेवत आहात, Okay, temperature falls down of the atmosphere and gradually it freezes. Okay, when it increases, the vapor pressure obviously is going to cause melting. And this is more seen as far as latent heat jo sagla equation hai. This can actually be well understood when we are speaking about evaporation. Okay, because otherwise we say that for water to vaporize or evaporate, okay, it needs to go beyond 100 degrees centigrade. And you'll see that normal water in the oceans obviously is not 100 degrees centigrade. So vapor pressure causes liberation of water molecules from the surface layers of the oceans, and that is how they gradually go into a vaporized format. Okay, we'll just go into the details of that in some moment of time. Okay, yeah, we have time, so possibly we'll reach that as such. It requires 80 kilocalories to melt 1 gram of ice, an amount referred to as latent heat of melting. Okay, latent heat of melting. And freezing is the reverse process, releases 80 calories per gram to the environment as the latent heat of fusion. Similarly, on this side, latent heat of vaporization and latent heat of condensation. Now, under certain conditions, heat may be added to a substance without an accompanying rise in the temperature. As I said, that water, temperature of water in oceans, heat is not applied to it. Okay, it is not, it's not actually heating as such. Or say, for example, another example, when ice in a glass of water melts, okay, you are not applying heat, isn't it? Okay, you'll see that it's a very hot day and you pour in some water in a glass, and then you feel that it's not very pleasant to drink it, so you take a few cubes of ice and you drop them into the ice and into the glass of water as such. Gradually what happens is that the ice starts growing smaller in size and its temperature is imparted gradually into the water. You are not actually applying force. Then why is it that ice in the glass of water melts? The temperature of the mixture remains constant, 0 degrees. Okay, until all the ice has melted. If the added energy does not raise the temperature of ice, where does this energy go? Okay, in this case, the added energy breaks the hydrogen bond that once bound the water molecules into a crystalline structure. Okay, so you'll see that it breaks off. Okay, this crystalline structure that builds up the hydrogen oxygen together to form water as such. Okay, and it gives you an ice cube that is broken. Okay, and it comes into a flow, that's the liquid form of water as such. Because the heat used to melt ice does not produce a temperature change, it is referred to as latent heat. Latent, because you don't see actually heat being given out, taken in, and so on and so forth. That's why it is called as latent, hidden heat. This energy is essentially stored in the liquid water and is released into the surroundings as the heat when the solid when the liquid returns to the solid state. Okay, so those 80 calories which were taken for melting will stay there, and of course will be released when they are once again freezes into ice as such. Okay, so things will be clear when we go into further slides as such. Now, the first two parts, which are more important and which are more seen, evaporation and condensation. This is something which very, very regularly happens with water around us, and that's why looking into that is very important also as such. Okay, you'll see that towards the right side, I've pasted a GIF image which gives you evaporation, and while the water molecules are evaporating, the size of the cloud is increasing, and you'll see that the sun is very happy that it is able to beam down its energy, and this energy is being utilized for the process of evaporation. Remember, again, let me tell you, you would immediately ask me a question, sir, you just now said that it is all latent heat, and how do you say that the sun is actually heating the earth's the water? No, the sun is actually heating the temperature, say the atmosphere, And it is the change in the air temperature which is now going to create what is called as vapor pressure, etc., etc. And that is how the evaporation is going to take place in a latent form. It is not actually that the sun is heating the surfaces. It is actually warming up the atmosphere. It's not warming up the temperature. And even if some part of it is being used, remember that ice cube that we had put in the glass of water, that unless and until the whole temperature will stabilize, you'll see that the water temperatures will not rise. Okay, so that is what is we come to the two most important point: evaporation and condensation, Bashpibhavan and Sandribhavan, jala apan manto. Latent heat is involved during evaporation, the process of converting a liquid into a gas. Okay, the energy absorbed by water molecules during evaporation is used to give them motion needed to escape from the surface of the liquid that becomes a gas. The energy is referred to as latent heat of vaporization and varies from 600 calories per gram of water to water at 0 degrees to 540 calories per gram at 100 degrees centigrade. Now you see why it is 600 here. Okay, this is 600. Okay, and it is 540 here. Why is the variation? The variation is basically because the energy, the latent heat varies, okay, from about 600 calories at 0 degrees to 540 calories per gram. 600 calories per gram for water at 0 degrees to 540 calories at 100 degrees. Yeah, at 100 degrees centigrade as such. In the earlier figure, it takes much more energy to evaporate 1 gram of water than it does to take one same amount of ice. Okay, melt same amount. Okay, you will see that it was only 80 calories here. It is 540. So that's another difference that we have to keep in mind. During the process of evaporation, the higher temperature molecules escape the surface. As a result, the average molecular motion of the remaining water is lower. Hence, the expression evaporation is a cooling process. I'll just explain it to you in a simple words. Now, what does this say? This paragraph say, during the process of evaporation, the higher temperature, faster moving molecules escape the surface. As a result, the average molecular motion of the remaining water is lowered. Hence, the expression evaporation is a cooling process. Okay, that's why you feel cool after a bath as such, because while taking bath, what you have done is all the water is there, then you clean off the water, but still the water has brought down the temperature and you still have some water on the surface. Okay, this tends to get evaporated. In the process, what happens, the energy for evaporation is taken from the whole surface, and that's why you feel cool as such. Or I'll give you another example. It's already summer now and you use those earthen pots. Apan matiche math vaparto pani gar karayla. Okay, ta he pani gar kaso hoto, tar tumhi pahal ki tumhi tyachatne pani kadle nahit tari halu 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 tumhi ek divas tya mathala hat nahi lavla, don divas tya mathala hat nahi lavle, te pani tase cha tase rahnar nahiye. Okay, te pani hecho bashpibhavan honar ahe. Mhanje kay hoto, tar ani apan तो मातीचा का घेतो माठ, ओके, कारण त्या मातीतनं पाणी झिरपत आणि इट कम्स टू द सर्फेस, बाहेरचा सर्फेस. ओके, फ्रॉम देअर, के इथे जसं लिहिलेलं आहे की वॉटरच्या सर्फेसवर, तिकडं वॉटरचा सर्फेस, ऑन अन ओशन इट्स द वॉटर सर्फेस, इन अन अर्दन पॉट इट इज द आउटर मोस्ट लेअर विच इज बिंग वेटेड. नाउ व्हॉट हॅपन्स इज द टेम्परेचर आउटसाइड, इट्स नॉट द सन, अगेन लेट मी टेल यू, इट्स नॉट द सन, इट्स द टेम्परेचर आउटसाइड, the temperature of the air outside. Okay, there is an indifference. This is the temperature outside and this is the outermost surface of the earthen pot. Maticha mathacha ha sagalyat baherta surface ahe ani he air temperature ahe. There is a difference. This is warmer, this is cooler. Okay, because of the pressure exerted by this warm thing, okay, the water from here will evaporate. Okay, it will start moving in higher motion and it will evaporate from here and it will join here. So the loss of all that energy, the loss of all that energy for one molecule to leave here and enter here, की कोणी भला हे बिल कोणी भरायचं, हे बिल कुणाच्या नावाने फाटणार आहे. दिस बिल इज गोइंग टू बी पेड बाय द वॉटर इन साईड. की इट हॅज टू लेट गो दॅट मच अमाऊंट ऑफ एनर्जी. बिकॉज इट लेट गोज दॅट मच अमाऊंट ऑफ एनर्जी, द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द वॉटर इन द पॉट इज गोइंग टू गो डाऊन. अँड दॅट इज हाऊ इन अ व्हेरी सिम्पल वे द टेम्परेचर ऑफ वॉटर इन अन अर्दन पॉट डिक्रीजेस वेन वी यूज दीज अर्दन पॉट्स ड्युरिंग समर एज सच. अगेन व्हेरी सिमिलर टू आपल्याला अंघोळीनंतर थंडी का वाजते, दॅट्स बेसिकली बिकॉज ऑफ द सेम प्रोसेस ऑन अ लार्ज स्केल. वी आर गोइंग टू गो इन टू फर्दर मोर डिटेल of this to happen around us as such. Okay, then if this is evaporation mi halu 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 tumhala tya klishta prakara parent neto ahe. Okay, you would say ki sir sarkha sarkha magascha pahilya slide madhe evaporation condensation, second slide madhe evaporation condensation, ikade ta sarani sagle lihun thevlele ahe evaporation condensation. I am gradually increasing the intensity of the complexity. Okay, so that एकदम हे अंगावर आल्यासारखं वाटणार नाही आणि असं घाबरून काही बाबा आपल्याला कळत नाही इव्हॅपोरेशन काय आणि कॉन्डेन्सेशन नाही, हे असं होऊ नये. म्हणून आय एम टेकिंग यू इन टू द ऍक्च्युअल प्रोसेस स्टेप बाय स्टेप. सो व्हॉट इज कंडेन्सेशन? कंडेन्सेशन इज द रिव्हर्स प्रोसेस ऑफ व्हॉट? इट्स द रिव्हर्स प्रोसेस ऑफ इव्हॅपोरेशन. इट अकर्स वेन द वॉटर वेपर चेंजेस बॅक टू लिक्विड स्टेट. ड्युरिंग कंडेन्सेशन water molecules release energy, that's the latent heat of condensation, is the amount equivalent to the what was absorbed during evaporation. jevde evaporation madhe hote tevde ata kadun takle. When condensation occurs in the atmosphere, it results in the formation of fog and clouds. Latent heat plays an important role in many atmospheric processes. It is this latent heat, mi magashi mhatle ki gadgadna किंवा लाईट निघतात हा तर एक पार्ट झाला, देर आर सो मेनी अदर थिंग्स विच आर ऍक्च्युअली हॅपनिंग बिकॉज ऑफ दिस लेटेंट हीट. इन पर्टिक्युलर वेन वॉटर वेपर कंडेन्सेस इन टू टू फॉर्म क्लाउड ड्रॉपलेट्स, लेटेंट हीट इज रिलीज विच वॉर्म्स द सराउंडिंग एअर अँड गिव्स इट बॉयन्सी. बॉयन्सी म्हणजे द टेंडन्सी टू गो अप, बॉयन्सी. ओके, म्हणजे तुम्ही फुग्यामध्ये जर एखादा गॅस भरला तर द balloon gets buoyant and it starts going up. When the moisture content of the air is high, this process can spur the growth of towering storm clouds. In addition, the evaporation of water over the tropical oceans and the subsequent condensation at higher latitudes results in a significant energy transfer from the equatorial region to the poleward location. Now here I would like to clarify one thing. If you remember, we have been speaking about the fact that the total amount of insulation of all the latitudes, the total amount of insulation is maximum at the equator. But you'll see that if the insulation is maximum, obviously the temperatures should be maximum at the equator, which they are not. This is basically because of this process, that evaporation takes up a lot of this energy into the upper layer and it's released into the condensation into the condensation layer. Say beyond 1.5 kilometers up there, and it is that energy which is then used in lightning, thunder, and that's what keeps the temperatures along the equator in a balance. Okay, they don't go very high and they don't go very low. They don't go very low basically because insulation is a regular phenomenon, saura prarana apan je adhi mhatlelo, and they don't go low basically because of insulation. They don't go high basically because of the process of evaporation using up a lot of this energy as such. Okay, and of course then apan je pahila ki the Hadley cell is carrying all this into into the latitudes of higher value, from where the Ferrel cell is going to carry it further, from where you will see that they get colder and colder and moves all the way into the polar cycle or polar cell as such. So I always keep reminding you of the fact that all of this is connected, and unless and until you know the connections between them, understanding climatology as a whole process is a bit difficult, I would say. Okay, tar pratyek veles mi kal ka parvacha lecture madhe sudha mhatlo ki we have to understand this at a unit, and then immediately after having understood it as a unit, you need to apply it to the other elements of the study of climatology as such. Okay, so that is as far as evaporation and condensation is concerned. And then you'll see that if you remember what we had done here, this is sublimation and this is deposition. What is sublimation and deposition as such? I could not get the diagrams for or photographs for sublimation, but I have them for deposition here. But let us first see sublimation is the conversion of solid directly into gas. Because it transfers into gas, you don't have a photograph of that as such without passing through the liquid state. Okay, it does not enter the liquid state, directly goes into to be a gaseous state as such. Examples you may have observed include the gradual shrinkage of unused ice cubes in the freezer and the rapid conversion of dry ice. तुम्ही पहाल की देन आजकाल आता हे जे इंजेक्शन्स वगैरे आहेत ओके पर्टिक्युलरली दिस कोविशील्ड एक्सेट्रा इंजेक्शन्स दे रिक्वायर टू बी स्टोर्ड ऍट अ व्हेरी लो टेम्परेचर एज सच नाउ व्हॉट हॅपन्स इज यू कॅन यूज आईस दॅट्स नॉर्मल आईस एज सच बट इव्हेंच्युअली द आईस इज गोइंग टू मेल्ट अँड दॅट वॉटर मे हार्म दॅट पर्टिक्युलर injection or vaccine as such. Instead what they use, dry ice is also frozen carbon dioxide. If you take dry ice, that's frozen carbon dioxide, you and you put it or you put it on a table, what is going to happen is that the dry ice will go through a process of sublimation, and right from dry ice it will sublime into carbon dioxide. There will not be anything called as liquid carbon dioxide. This process is called as and to khada tumhi thevla tar normally ek dry ice cha khada ghetla tumhi ani normal ice cha khada ghetla and you put it together side by side, you will see that after some time the ice is going to leave back water, but dry ice will not even will not even leave behind any mark as such, because it directly transforms into carbon dioxide which vaporizes around us as such. Okay, just like condensation was an exactly opposite process to evaporation, deposition is an exactly opposite process to sublimation. Refers to a reverse process, the conversion of vapor directly to solid. This change occurs, for example, when water vapor is deposited as ice on solid objects such as grass or windows. Tya grass manal tar tela frost manto apan. These deposits are called as white frost or simply frost. A household example of the process of deposition is the frost that accumulates in the freezer. Tumhi pahal ki barach veles tumhi freezer madhe pani ta thevlel nasto pan tashi pandri powder je ahe hi sagli tumcha tya freezer la atun laglele asti. Tumhi hat phirvla ki ti basbas khali padte लाकडाच्या भुशासारखी गार असते बरीच. दॅट्स बेसिकली फ्रॉस्ट एज सच. डिपॉझिशन रिलीजेस एन अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी इक्वल टू दॅट विच इज रिलीज्ड बाय कंडेन्सेशन ऑर फ्रीझिंग. कंडेन्सेशन अँड फ्रीझिंग एज सच. जस्ट अनदर एक्झाम्पल, हिअर इज अन एक्झाम्पल ऑफ हाऊ फ्रॉस्टिंग टेन्स टू टेक प्लेस. ओके, दिस इज हाऊ फ्रॉस्ट हॅज ग्रोन ऑन द लीव्स एज सच. And one more thing is here. Okay, you'll see ki this is which is a zavalun microscopic photo kadle ta atishay sundar pattern asto. It's pointed and it's very flaky. Okay, so that is as far as sublimation and deposition is concerned. Now for deposition to take place, normally for deposition to take place, the temperature of the air should be around 0 degrees. Okay, why I'm saying this is I'll give you an example that when you take a cold drink bottle out of a refrigerator and you put it in your house, what happens after some time, condensation takes place, and on the outer side of that particular bottle of cold drink, water droplets do occur. Now if you do the same process at 0 degrees as such, okay, in the sense that the refrigerator temperature is in minus, okay, you pull out that cold water bottle, and what you do is you put it in an area where the temperature of the room temperature upon room temperature temperature room temperature which is around 0 degrees. What is going to happen is that the water vapor in that particular room will deposit, go into the process of deposition, and you'll see that directly ice crystals will formulate on the outer side of this particular water bottle. The process of sublimation and deposition for you. We move further and let us understand what is all that role, and what, before we understand how all these things are happening, let us look into a few aspects about water vapor in further more detail as such. Towards the left of your screen, you will find a circular diagram, which, and in the diagram, it's basically a parcel of air. In this parcel of air, you will find different gases. The two major gases that you find, nitrogen is one, and oxygen is one, another one. Oxygen is darker in color, I would say a greenish in color, and nitrogen is a bit reddish in color. And then you have that molecule with two white dots around it, and that's water vapor. Now, this obviously is going to be a condition, a hypothetical condition, basically because of the fact that if we go by scale, obviously nitrogen is supposed to be 71 parts, oxygen is supposed to be 20 parts. Okay, and water vapor is going to be less. Of course, we know that it's a dynamic proportion, and it could change from one aspect to the other. That means from as low as 0.04%, it could be as high as 4% also as such. Okay, so it varies. And this variation actually is called as humidity. So gradually, jala apan water vapor manat hoto, exclusively water vapor. Now, water vapor is not an entity by itself. It exists along with other elements of gas around it as such, elements of air, I would say. And that proportion of water vapor with regards nitrogen, oxygen, okay. Now what happens is, because of the dynamism of water vapor, you don't have to compare it with every gas, because all other gases are stable. It is water vapor that is dynamic. So an easier thing to do is to compare water vapor with rest of the air. Okay, why I'm telling you, because all of this is going to be required now. Thodasa klisht aahe, pan tumhi laksha dilat, this is going to be easy. Okay, what we are doing, we started with the looking at the parcel of air, and in the parcel of air you had nitrogen, oxygen, of course you're going to have krypton, but the density, the percentage is very low, and that's why not seeing in here. You're going to have carbon dioxide, which is not seen here, but water vapor is very high now, and that's why you can see at least around 5 molecules of water in this as such. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so because others are not going to change, we don't have to compare it with oxygen and carbon dioxide, you know, and nitrogen and so on and so forth. All you have to do is rest of the air separate and water, because water vapor can add into this and come out of this at its will. Jeva jeva conditions nirman hotil teva teva water vapor add will kashamul evaporation mul, ani water vapor hyachyatna bahir il kashamul condensation mul. Samajhte? So that is what is going to happen, and that's why, instead of making it complex by relating it to other gases, all other gases is one group, that's air. All other gases together is air, and water vapor is going to get into it, and water vapor is going to come out of it as water vapor constitutes only a small fraction of the atmosphere, varying from as little as 0.1% up to about 4% by volume. But the importance of water in the air is far greater than these small percentages indicate. In fact, water vapor is the most important gas in the atmosphere when it comes to atmospheric processes. Okay, just agar atmospheric processes ghadna rahe, water vapor is main karanibhut hai tha. Humidity is a general term, coming to that. Humidity is a general term used to describe the amount of water vapor in the air. Mi magashi mhantlo na, kiti water vapor hai. Okay, that is actually the technical term used is humidity kiti hai. Instead of asking ki air madhe water vapor kiti hai, we say that what is the humidity of the air as such. And meteorologists employ several methods to express this water vapor content. Nemka kiti ahe water vapor air madhe. Okay, it is understood in various terms. There are five terms. Okay, five terms in the sense it's not the same thing which is being explained. All these are different conditions of humidity. Okay, with regards pressure, temperature of the air. Okay, ya sagalyachi ek gammat asnar ahe. Ani that's why they are identified as five different. Neither humidity sagli humidities rahili asti na. Why are we calling them by different names? Okay, ani ugach kai ki ise asa ta navta ki baba MMSC part 1 che students la first semester madhe far baki sagla sopa ahe. Tyachyamule apan thodase he avghad karu ani nusty humidity la apan vegvegli nav deuyat. Kuthe tela absolute humidity mhanu, vapor pressure mhanu, relative humidity mhanu, dew point mhanu, asa nahi. That yes, it is related to water vapor, but the conditioning of each of this is different, and that's why meteorologists call them with different names at different conditions. One is absolute humidity, which we are going to do immediately. This is going to be followed by mixing ratio. This is going to be followed by vapor pressure. Okay, if we have time today, we will be reaching that. I don't think we'll have that much of time. And then you come to relative humidity, and finally it comes to dew point. Dew point is nothing but he je adhich pahilan apan he fakt this is dew point at a very low temperature. Dew point is sangri bhavan ke in simple words. Okay, tyamule he pan atishay garjeche ahe ki yalach ajun kay mhantat yalach ajun kay mhantat he jevda tumhi tumhala savay laun ghyal particularly ya topic cha babtit ke evda te sopa hoil samjayla na. Two of these methods, absolute humidity and mixing ratio, are similar in that both are expressed as the quantity of water vapor contained in a specific amount of air. Okay, tumhi ek amount of air ghetli ani tyachyamadhe tumhi mojayla suruvat keli ki yachyamadhe water vapor kiti ahe. That's going to be called as either absolute humidity or mixing ratio. Now, why do we call it as absolute humidity, and at the same time why are we calling it mixing ratio? There is a bit of difference in this, and that is what we are going to try and understand. And to understand the exact difference between these two, we have to understand what each of them actually mean in a scientific way. Okay, what they mean actually in a scientific way. Absolute humidity is the mass of water vapor. Mass, okay, actual water vapor kiti hai in a given volume of air, usually expressed in grams per cubic meter. Okay, what is weight? Mass into gravity is weight. Ata he sagle light hai, in spite of the fact gravity is affecting it, that is going to be called as mass. Okay, and that's why you'll see that it is in a given volume of air. Yacha madhe ata he dynamic hai, we don't know what it is. Okay, so in a given volume of air, how much of water vapor is going to be there is called as absolute humidity. That's a formula kai. You must have done this in your practicals in your undergraduate classes. I'm not very sure about this, but absolute humidity is the mass of water vapor in grams, volume of air in cubic meters. Okay, you take a cube. Okay, एवढी एअर घेतली तुम्ही, दिस इज द क्यूब, एवढी एअर घेतली, याच्यातलं वॉटर वेपर जे आहे मी एक्स्ट्रॅक्ट केलं, फक्त वॉटर वेपर एक्स्ट्रॅक्ट केलं, बाकीची एअर आहे तशीच राहिली. दिस इज अ क्यूब. ओके, आय एम गोइंग टू सी हाऊ मच ऑफ द डायमेन्शन ऑफ दिस. लेट अस से दिस इज वन क्युबिक मीटर फॉर एक्झाम्पल, द व्हॉल्यूम ऑफ एअर इज वन क्युबिक मीटर, अँड आय एम गोइंग टू एक्स्ट्रॅक्ट ओनली वॉटर वेपर आउट ऑफ दिस. I'm going to measure that kiti grams hai. That's going to give me the absolute humidity at that moment of time in this volume. This much is the amount of water vapor in this volume. Absolute humidity. Okay, can we understand it in a larger extent? Yes. As water moves from one place to other, sorry, as air moves from one place to other, changes in the pressure and temperature causes change in its volume. when such volume changes occur, the absolute humidity also changes. Even if no water vapor is added or removed, consequently, it is difficult to monitor the water vapor content of a moving mass of air. Okay, when using the absolute humidity index. Therefore, meteorologists prefer the use of mixing ratio to express water vapor content in the air. Now, what does this actually mean? Why is it not very advisable to use absolute humidity? Now, let me see. This is the same volume of air. And let us say ki yachyamadhye 5 gram water vapor hai. How much? 5 gram water vapor is there. Now, this is mean sea level. When this goes up, the pressure on this is going to decrease. When the pressure of this is going to decrease, you'll see that this will expand. Okay, this will expand. When this expands, what happens? Okay, when this expands, the temperature will fall down. When the temperature is going to be falling down, obviously, the same thing which has now expanded, the amount of water vapor it can now hold is going to be less. Now, this is vertical. Horizontally also this will happen. This is at the equator. This will move into mid-latitude. This will move into the poles. This is hypothetical theory. It does not happen so fast. Okay, because the surface of the earth is so much in distance. The curvature is so much as such. But then equator, the temperature is going to be different. You move this way, mid-latitude, the temperature is going to be different. You bring it to poles, the temperature is going to be different. The volume remains the same. Possibly, the volume remains the same. The amount of water vapor that it can hold will change horizontally as well as vertically. And that's why when I calculate the absolute humidity here, it's going to be different. Absolute humidity here is going to be different. Absolute humidity here is going to be different. That's one. Absolute humidity here is going to be different. Absolute humidity here is going to be different. Absolute humidity here is going to be different as such. This becomes very confusing, and that's why we go to what is called as mixing ratio. What is mixing ratio? Okay, let me see how much time. Yes, I'll finish this, and then we'll try to come back and understand what all this is. Okay, as I said, towards the right of your screens, this is that small round circle that you can see here. And when it goes up, what happens? The pressure on it is released, and then as a consequence, what happens is that the size of the same bubble has increased. So phuga jo hai, okay, to budubuda jo hai, okay, tyachyavarcha pressure kami zalyamule it has expanded. And let us understand what actually has happened as such. Okay, mass of the parcel of air is 1 kg. Dry air, yeah? This is dry. Mass of a parcel, 1 kg. Remember, the size has increased, the mass remains the same, 1 kg. Okay, now size of the parcel, this is 1 cubic meter. At a particular height, it has gone to 2 cubic meters. Mass remains the same, but okay, because of the loss of pressure, what has happened is the size has increased. That's one side of this diagram. The other side, what you'll see, what is the absolute humidity here? What is the absolute humidity here at this rate? This is 20 grams per cubic meter. 20 grams per cubic meter. Okay, because the mass of water vapor is 20 grams. Okay, the water vapor in this is 20 grams. Okay, and the mixing ratio, je aplyala karaycha ajun, apan fakta absolute humidity kelele, mixing ratio is 20 grams per kg. Okay, 20 grams per kg. Ata gammat baga ki yacha unit 20 grams per cubic meters. Cubic meters madhe 20 grams hai. Mixing ratio 1 kilo madhe 20 grams hai. Lakshyat yete ata weight ani mass madhe farak. When it goes up, what is happening? Just see, the mass of the water vapor remains the same, 20 grams. However, the absolute humidity has now changed. It has gone half. Karan ka zalele? Karan his size jai hi 2 zalele. So So this is going to be 10 grams only. हे लगेच समजेल असं नाही. हळूहळू याच्याकडे लक्ष देऊन व्यवस्थित बारकाव्याने हे परत ऐकलं लेक्चर डेफिनेटली समजणार, याच्यामध्ये काहीही प्रॉब्लेम नाही. हाऊ एव्हर द मिक्सिंग रेशियो, एका किलोमध्ये किती होत? एका किलोमध्ये हे 20 ग्रॅम होत. मग हा एक किलो इकडे तेवढाच राहिला, हा एक किलो तेवढाच राहिला, त्याच्यामुळे याची मिक्सिंग रेशियो जो आहे हा तेवढाच राहिला. पण ऍब्सोल्युट ह्युमिडिटी मध्ये काय झालं, यु आर कन्सिडरिंग द व्हॉल्यूम, हा व्हॉल्यूम वाढला आणि त्याचं प्रपोर्शन घेत आहे. त्या व्हॉल्यूम मध्ये किती आहे, लक्षात येत आहे, त्या व्हॉल्यूम मध्ये किती आहे. अर्थातच छोट्या व्हॉल्यूम मध्ये ते तुम्हाला जास्त वाटणार कारण तो रेशियो आहे. तेवढंच पाणी मोठ्या व्हॉल्यूम मध्ये, तेवढंच पाणी हे मोठ्या व्हॉल्यूम मध्ये तुम्ही जर घेतलं, ओके, लेट अस अज्युम दॅट दिस इज द इन्क्रीज्ड व्हॉल्यूम, एकच मिनिट, लेट अस से दिस इज टू, ओके. व्हॉट हॅपन्स इज दिस इज द ओरिजिनल व्हॉल्यूम ऍट द सर्फेस. व्हेन दिस गोज अप, व्हॉट इज गोइंग टू हॅपन, त्याचा व्हॉल्यूम वाढलेला आहे. 20 ग्रॅम ह्याच्यात पण होतं, 20 ग्रॅम ह्याच्यात पण आहे, पण काय झालं आता की याच्यात त्या 20 ग्रॅमची गर्दी झालेली आहे, याच्यात ते 20 ग्रॅम विरळ झालेला आहे, याच्यामध्ये 20 ग्रॅम विरळ झालेला आहे. आणि त्याच्यामुळे तो फरक आहे की याच्यात जे तुम्हाला 20 ग्रॅम पर क्युबिक मीटर होत, त्यात तेच 20 तुम्ही जास्त एरियामध्ये डिस्ट्रीब्यूट केलेलं आहे, हे 10 ग्रॅम्स पर क्युबिक मीटर झालं. हे जास्तच कन्फ्युजिंग होतं. Because that is confusing, normally meteorologists will not use this particular technique to understand or to measure the amount of water vapor. But water vapor is an important thing. We have to measure it because it's the rainfall and other things are going to be dependent on water vapor. So we take what is called as mixing ratio. Mixing ratio is the mass of water vapor per unit of air compared to the remaining mass of air. Okay, mixing ratio is equal to the mass of water vapor in grams. What mass of water vapor in grams and mass of total dry air in kilograms. Because it is a measurement, because it is measured in units of mass, usually grams per kilogram. Ithe thodasa to formula ghyaycha rahila maza. I'll correct it immediately after the lecture, and then when we meet next time we'll go into once again, of course we're going to revise all this because this is definitely not going to finish it off at this particular moment of time, because there are few more concepts that we need to understand unless and until we come to the last point, that is the dew point. All the five we have to understand. Of this first one we have understood what is absolute humidity. Now we are coming to mixing ratio. Eka kilo madhe kiti aahe. Ata he kilo tumhi kuthe ghun ja, हे किलो तुम्ही कुठेही घेऊन जा, तुम्ही वर नेलं तर ह्याची वजन कमी होणार आहे, बट दॅट इज नॉट गोइंग टू गिव्ह यू अ मिक्सिंग रेशियो. सो ऍट एन ऍट दॅट हाईट यू हॅव टू अगेन गॅदर 1 kg, ऍट दिस हाईट यू आर गोइंग टू कीप दॅट 1 kg, ऍट द इक्वेटर यू हॅव टू कलेक्ट 1 kg टू गेट अ मिक्सिंग रेशियो. फरक बघा आता, व्हॉट इज द डिफरन्स बिटवीन ऍब्सोल्यूट ह्युमिडिटी अँड मिक्सिंग रेशियो. ओके, इक्वेटर आय हॅव टू कलेक्ट 1 kg, मिड लॅटिट्यूड आय हॅव टू कलेक्ट 1 kg, poles I have to collect 1 kg, at the surface I am to collect 1 kg, at the height I have to collect 1 kg, and see how much of water is there, how many water molecules are there. So what is the amount of water that is mixed, what is the ratio between water and the 1 kg of air? That's the mixing ratio. Okay, that's called as the mixing ratio. And you'll see that because every time you have to see that you have to collect 1 kg, the mixing ratio is not affected. The mixing ratio is not affected by changes in pressure and temperature. Karan tya pressure la tumhala 1 kilo gola karayche, tya temperature la tumhala 1 kilo gola karayche. That's the basic difference between mixing ratio and absolute humidity as such. Then we come to the next, another commonly used expression is specific humidity, which is the mass of water vapor in a unit mass of air including the water vapor. Because the amount of water vapor in the air rarely exceeds a few percent of total mass of air, the specific humidity of air is equivalent to its mixing ratio for all practical purposes. What does this mean? In short, that the mixing ratio and specific humidity are nothing but same values. It is the mass of water vapor in a unit mass of air. But here, it can be any, but you have to keep the proportion the same. जे इथे मी 2 किलो मध्ये हे किती आहे आणि ते तिकडे गेल्यावर त्याचा फरक पडलं नाही, इथे सुद्धा मला 2 किलोच लागेल. बिकॉज द अमाऊंट ऑफ वॉटर वेपर इन द एअर रेअरली एक्सीड्स अ फ्यू परसेंट ऑफ द टोटल मास ऑफ एअर, द स्पेसिफिक ह्युमिडिटी ऑफ द एअर इज इक्विवॅलंट टू इट्स मिक्सिंग रेशियो फॉर ऑल प्रॅक्टिकल पर्पजेस. इन अदर वर्ड्स, मिक्सिंग रेशियो अँड स्पेसिफिक ह्युमिडिटी आर वन अँड द सेम. नीदर द ऍब्सोल्यूट ह्युमिडिटी नॉर द मिक्सिंग रेशियो, however, can be easily determined by direct sampling. Therefore, okay, this is a sample tumhi ghiu shakat nahi na. All practical purposes, 1 kilo kutnanar tumhi air. Tyachyamule he sagla theoretical ahe. You can't actually generate 1 kg of air or 1 cubic meter of air and so on and so forth. Therefore, there are other methods, okay, which are more, easily understood, other methods, okay, are used to express the moisture content in air. What are those methods? Okay, this is basically the process. What are those methods? Okay, these are nothing but ikade je apan lihilele ahe. Okay, vapor pressure. The third is vapor pressure, relative humidity and dew point. These three are now remaining. Vapor pressure, relative humidity and dew point. As such, we have finished with mixing ratio. We are finished with absolute humidity, and next time we meet, we are going to go into what is called as vapor pressure, and then of course we'll have to go into relative humidity and so on and so forth. Okay, and eventually we'll come up with dew point also. Now, for a moment, I'm going to stop here for today, and what I'm going to do is I'll stop sharing. I will end my show here, and I'll come back to you as such. Now, of whatever we have done today, if you have any queries, please ask me. Amuk kalla nahi tamuk kalla nahi, mi maza presentation ready thevlela ahe, and at any point of time you can just ask me ki sir, please explain this particular thing. I would in fact suggest ki aajcha lecture tumhi parat pahana garjecha ahe, karan mi punha tumhi mhantle sir he nahi kalan, mi te explain kela आणि त्या स्पीडला मी तुमच्या समजण्याच्या स्पीडला मॅच नाही होऊ शकलो तर यू वुड अगेन नॉट अंडरस्टँड इट, आणि थोडीशी भीती वाढेल. आय वुड से की इन सम टाइम फ्रॉम नाव आय विल डाउनलोड दिस लेक्चर, आय विल अपलोड इट ऑन माय युट्यूब चॅनल, अँड यू कॅन सी दिस लेक्चर एज सच. बट ऍट इमिजिएटली यू फील दॅट ओके दिस इज समथिंग दॅट आय हॅव नॉट ॲट ऑल अंडरस्टूड, यू कॅन आस्क मी दॅट क्वेश्चन अँड आय विल ऑब्विसली गिव्ह यू अन आन्सर अँड ट्राय टू गिव्ह यू अन आन्सर फॉर दॅट. While you think about the question, let me just check your attendance. Aishwarya Limaye, Akshay Harwude, Pratik Kokde, Pritam Ghosh, Revati Shinde, Rohit Gaikwad, Rushikesh Aglave, Sharayut Takavane, Shreya Chavan, Sunil Rathod, Sunil Tushar Kothule, Usha Vasave, Vandita Bhamre. Okay, is are the students present today? If you have no questions for me, I should be calling it a day. Have a good weekend, good in the sense safe weekend. Don't go around. Punyatlya lokanna particularly sangtoy, don't move around. The number in Maharashtra has already crossed 35,000, so literally except for Pritam, everybody is from Maharashtra. Don't take any risk of any sort. Try to stay away from people. You don't know who is a carrier, who is actually infected, and so on and so forth. Okay, at times you yourself could be a carrier, so you stay safe and keep people safe also. That's all for today then. If you have no questions,